Everybody, it's 1123 JBC. I don't know if that fully caught it, but whatever, I don't care. How are we all doing today? In this episode, we are going to take on Cypher Pole number 9 in the Watcher 7 saga, which I fanboyed enough about in the last episode. episode before that. In this episode, we're going to be taking on this action stage, and I believe this is the stage I don't like because of the R1-1 thing that really annoys me. There are some things I got to show, but three square, one triangle, four square, one triangle, and the Gum Gum Storm, so I gotta remember to do that. Probably do the combos now, so I can show you guys what it looks like, but Let's see, I don't know what I want to say. This is such a great saga. And the, why do I have like 20 Wonka bottles in my room? Holy crap, I didn't realize I let things get too far. Yeah. Oh. Sorry, drank some water. Oh, shiz. Let me fix this real quick. You didn't hear the mouse click. Hopefully you didn't hear the keys click. I hope you didn't hear that one either. Or that one. Okay. Computer fan, begin! So, speaking of, like, recently coming into contact with other games, I recently got the Kingdom Hearts 1.5 remix for the PS3. Because of two things. One, I never got the chance to own Kingdom Hearts 1 or have fully played through it. And I have 100% the game. And by 100%, I mean got all the Dalmatians and did everything I could, except for the Synthesis, defeat Sephiroth, or the Ice Giant. I haven't done those three things, and I haven't done all the Gummy Ship missions. But other than that, I pretty much did everything I could. Like, I filled out Jiminy's things, I got the achievement for it. So yeah, basically with 1.5. God, why do I keep burping today? Holy crud. Basically with the 1.5 remixes, it comes with Kingdom Hearts 1 and Rechain of Memories for PS2. Those two games. And it comes with a theater mode, not the game, but theater mode for 358x2 days. And the real reason why I got that was to play through 358x2 days, because Miles has it, but he won't let me borrow it for whatever reason. And I wanted to play that game so badly, but I never got a chance to. And so when I heard it had the game in 1.5, that made me like blow my money on it. And then when I beat Kingdom Hearts 1, I decided to, you know, start 358x2 days. And then I realized it was I am brain farting right now. A theater mode. And that kind of destroyed my hopes and dreams of ever playing the game. So one of the things I wanted to do was play through every Kingdom Hearts game. I can't wait for the 2.5 remix to come out, because that one comes with Birth by Sleep. And that's another game I really wanted. It comes with 2, Birth by Sleep, and I want to say Coded? That might just be another theater mode, but I don't want to know. I don't really care for Coded all too much. Miles also has that game, but, you know, again, he won't let me borrow it. But, yeah, Birth by Sleep, that's the one I really wanted to play. And the reason why I didn't play it was because the Demon Children broke my PSP. And that's an interesting story. And I will share it with you guys, because it's an interesting story. But first, I want to show off the combos that we just got. So, let's do that, and then we'll talk about the story. So, okay. Alright, so first things first is 1, 2, 3 triangle. That is rocket. Cool. I don't care. The other one is 1, 2, 3, 4 strike. So that is the news that we got. So you're seeing in the upper left corner where the SP bars are, there is now two of them. Basically, the way to do storm is to fill up the bar all the way, and then instead of pressing triangle, you want to hold it until it fills up the second bar. Or at least in the second bar. And when it's in the second bar, you can do storm. So yeah, that's much it. That's two on the level. Alright, so... Excuse me. I don't know if I've said this story or not in the past. I'm gonna say not, but whatever. And now my face is itchy. Oh, I remember why I would be playing this. This is probably where to beat up a Viking because we beat up Usopp. Copper! Yeah, I wouldn't really link up with the characters in this point because we're going to be not using them. So. I mean, I guess I'll do it with the Iron 7. Okay. I've never seen that before. And Thunder! The lightning is so epic that I became Luffy. Alright. That I became Luffy, not the Thunder became Luffy. No, it was I came with it. Sorry. Yeah, so one day, I know these, let me just get my son, the Demon Trunk of Fedora. When I was a kid, I grew up in this town called Mount Vernon, New York. Apparently it's one of the rated as one of the worst cities in the world. I don't really know if that's true or not, or someone told me that. And I kinda didn't believe them. Whatever. I don't care. And so yeah. So I used to live in this place called Mount Vernon, New York. Used to. I don't anymore, now I live in college. Not that far away. Mount Vernon. Maybe a 5 minute drive to take the highway. I don't know why. I'm sorry if I keep hiccuping these things, but I don't know why. Oh, hey, look! I got a thing of the death! Swing my bit. My bat. My pole of death. Okay. So, I used to live in this place in Mount Vernon. And when I lived in Mount Vernon, I used to live in a house that was two families living in it. And my landlord was pretty chill and whatnot. And we used to play Kingdom Hearts. And other PS2 classics, and Crash Bandicoot, and things like that. And that's actually where I became a fan of Crash Bandicoot and Kingdom Hearts because of him. Actually, the reason why I became a huge Sony person was because of him. Was my landlord, it was more like his son. The person I'm talking about doesn't, you know, own the house, his family, that does. But, yeah. His name is Michael. So that's where I became a fan of Kingdom Hearts and other things, like PS2 classics, or PS1 classics, or so PS1. But, so yeah. And in this house, my neighbor was these family friends of ours, of my parents. My mom, because their mom, I think, worked in the same place that my mom used to work at. That's where they met. And they moved into my neighborhood where I used to live. So this is like a brief little history of where I used to live. Not that you guys asked for it, but I'm telling you anyway because I don't give a fuck. And. Wee! Oh, okay. Whee! So yeah. Did I redo this? Let's see if I have to redo this. I'm gonna do it anyway. I don't remember if I do or not. Oh, yeah. Okay, I guess I did. So, Faceless next to me. In 1.9, right? Used to live next to, or used to live above the person on my block, but they moved right next to where I live. And so, one day, their mom, the Demon Code mom, and my mom were making this traditional, like, Portuguese bread called latte. And it was during the summer, and I think it was that Christmas. Oh shit, they didn't do that. And that Christmas, I got a limited edition Star Wars. I hope to God I didn't just screw myself up. Okay, no. And as I say, no, I didn't. But limited edition Star Wars Darth Vader PSP. And it was so cool. It was white, and it had the Darth Vader back. And if you don't know this, I am a huge Star Wars fan. I love Star Wars. I haven't seen every Star Wars film, but I do love Star Wars. And I haven't really seen the six. But I've seen five and four. There's actually one of my more favorites, because I love the ending with Obi-Wan and Anakin. And one of the other ones. I love Darth Maul. That was like the only reasoning why I loved the first one. Even though people keep telling me that it was like the worst in the series, and I'm like, I love Darth Maul. He's like my favorite Star Wars villain. With a double lightsaber. Shit was badass. And the Demon Children are huge Star Wars fans, even though they've never seen a Star Wars movie in their life. But they they love Star Wars games and that sort of thing. They love lightsabers. So they also happened to be over my aunt's house that Christmas. Wait, I'm sorry, I gotta drink some more of this. My throat is itchy. Okay, sorry. So they happened to fall in love with my PSP, sorry. Also, because they... Thank you, game, for the hint, because I was lost. And they loved it because it was Star Wars related, but I loved it because it was cool looking. And it came with Battlefront 2, and I love Battlefront 2. So one day, their mom and my mom were making falafel, which is this traditional Portuguese bread, which I think I would explain. And I was playing on my PSP, and they were over, and they were watching me play Battlefront 2, and I also had Innocent Life, Future Harvest Moon, which I love that game to death. Yeah, I know. I played it. And you just click this drop in. Oh crap! Oh, now we're good. Okay. So yeah, and my mom calls out to me as they're making the bread, and she tells me to run to Getty, the gas station, and pick up a gallon of milk, because they're out of milk. I'm like, okay, cool. So I crash into a wall. No. So I run. Actually, before I run, I put my PSP down. And I tell the two demon children not to touch anything. And them being little kids, you know, they didn't listen to me. I was like 12 at this point, right? So I told them if they touched anything, I'd kick their ass. And I put it down, PSP, on my desk. Where they could have gotten it, and I was an idiot for doing it myself. So I run to Getty, and I leave the front door open, because I didn't want to put the keys in. So I ran to Getty, which was around the corner